and hello and welcome. We're coming to you from Maximum City. This is Amchi Mumbai. I am Poonam Burde. The election highway has reached Maharashtra, and what better way than to start from the financial capital of the country, Mumbai. You've seen, all you see is the Gateway of India, you see the Marine Drive, you see the Bandra Worli ceiling. But today we're coming from Borivali. It's part of North Mumbai. This is also a part of a constituency which is represented by a union minister. He is a candidate now. He is making his first foray into electoral politics. He's not new to politics or even to the parliament, but if elected, he's going to be new to the Lok Sabha for sure. Piyush Goyal will be joining us shortly. He's the candidate from Mumbai North, where I am standing from currently. We have some BJP karyakartas with us as well. The mood here is really upbeat. What really is Mumbai going to vote for? There are high profile constituencies, all of which vote on the 20th of May. The state of Maharashtra and the politics and the state of affairs here seems like it's in a muddle. What exactly is it that the voters are choosing from? BJP's mood is upbeat, not just in this constituency of Mumbai North, but across Mumbai. All of the constituencies are going to be with the NDA alliance. Is there confidence? Of course, the voters will decide. The Sena versus Sena fight will play out when Mumbai votes. We'll also see the Pawar factions and the two NCP factions fight it out. What is it going to be like as far as Mumbai is concerned? Let me try and get you a sense of why the BJP feels this is their election to win. बीजेपी में हमने देखा है, नॉट जस्ट दिस कंस्टिट्यूएंसी, बट मुंबई में जितनी सीटें बीजेपी लड़ रही है, महाराष्ट्र में जितनी सीटें बीजेपी लड़ रही है अलायंस में, सारी सीटों पे हम जीत हासिल करेंगे, ये एक कॉन्फिडेंस है. ये कॉन्फिडेंस कैसे आता है, कहां से आ रहा है?
देखिए, ऐसा है कि सबसे पहला कॉन्फिडेंस तो ये है कि हमारे साथ जो हमारा नेतृत्व कर रहे हैं वो नरेंद्र मोदी जी हैं, और वो जब कोई चीज की गारंटी देते हैं तो उसको पूरा करते हैं, और आने वाले दिनों में भी जो गारंटीज वो दे रहे हैं उसको पूरा करेंगे. तो ये पब्लिक का ही देन है कि पब्लिक समझती है कि जो कहते हैं वो करते हैं. तो भारतीय जनता पार्टी एक ऐसी पार्टी है जिन्होंने जो कहा उसको पूरा किया है. तो इसके लिए हमारे जितने भी लोग जो सपोर्टर्स हैं, ये जो है वो जानते हैं कि जो कहते हैं वो करते हैं. बाकी पार्टियों की तरह नहीं है, जो कहेंगे तो वादा तो इलेक्शन के टाइम बहुत करेंगे पर वो करेंगे कुछ नहीं. तो यहाँ पर मोदी है तो मुमकिन है, ये सबके मन में.
तो मोदी के नाम पे इलेक्शन लड़ा जा रहा है, बस मोदी के नाम पे इश्यूज मायने नहीं रखते, मोदी के नाम पे वोट पड़ेगा सारा.
100% मोदी है तो मुमकिन है.
The vote is going to be for the Prime Minister, for Narendra Modi. That's really what every single BJP karyakarta feels. That's what the BJP leaders feel as well. It's Modi's guarantee that does the magic. It's the Modi wave that is still on, not just here in Mumbai or in Maharashtra, but across the country. That is what gives the BJP confidence that the Mission 400 is still possible. Before we get you the candidate from Mumbai North, and Piyush Goyal, the Union Minister, will be joining us shortly. But before we get you that, let's also try and get you voices from other constituencies and what they and their fight looks like. I spoke to Ujjwal Nikam in the morning. Remember, he's a public prosecutor that has been in play as far as several high profile cases go. He's now in electoral fray. He is on a BJP ticket. He's fighting from the constituency of Mumbai North. What is his election plan going to be like? I spoke to him a short while ago. Listen in. From donning the lawyer's blacks to the proverbial kurta white of the politician, I'm joined by Ujjwal Nikam. He's the BJP's candidate from Mumbai North Central. I want to thank you for joining us, sir, for taking out the time from your busy campaign schedule. Yeah. We are less than a month away before Mumbai votes. What made you take the political plunge finally after so many decades as a lawyer?
It's not a political stand as such, but it's a calculated move of mine. You see, all the while, right from when I got the degree of law, I was fighting against the United Criminal. I never defended any criminal. And especially my interest was the national interest. And that is the reason, you see, many political parties had approached to me. But I have decided to enter into politics because now in my balance of life, I had to do for my nation. And that's why I have decided to enter into politics.
So this is your major plank, nationalism, national security, fighting for the country. Is that your election plank?
It is not only that, to serve for the common man. Because all the while fighting against the criminals, I was trying to give justice to those people who have been everything they had lost. But now, after joining the politics, one of the major my plank is that the national security, national interest, and secondly, what are the difficulties of a common man in general and in particular about my constituency.
You know, we're less than 1 month away before your constituency votes. Do you think you have enough time to campaign? Do you think your plank will resonate? There is enough time for people to understand what you're fighting for?
Yes, I believe. I firmly believe that yes, though I have a very late time, but I will do, because my colleagues are totally supporting me, and I am motivated by what our beloved Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Ji Modi, has said, that terror and talk can't go together. See, I was carefully listening his all speeches, and in every speech I found there is a current, and our youth is being motivated by his speeches. So I had decided to join, because ultimately I had to select national party. So I found that BJP is one of the strongest national party, who has having certain goals for the common man, who has definitely some specific plans for our country, and therefore I decided to join BJP.
You know, you spoke of your colleagues and them being supportive. You've replaced a sitting member of parliament in this constituency, Poonam Mahajan. You know her family. You've been a prosecutor for her father's case as well. So many would say that you're an outsider politically, so to say. She was a sitting member of parliament, comes from a political family. You're up against someone who's also had electoral success. She's been the MLA here as well. How do you think you fare in that fight?
See, firstly, I will discard your allegation that I am an outsider. I am not an outsider at all, because since 1993, I am fighting for the people of Mumbai. Listen, 93 Mumbai city was rocked, a series of the powerful bomb blasts. Thereafter, there was a terror attack on Mumbai, the twin bomb, and so many cases. I was defending the people who have been lost everything. So ultimately, this allegation is not correct that I'm an outsider. I'm very much Mumbaikar, number one. Number two, I served my life, major life, for the better settlement of the people of Mumbai. And thirdly, so far as you have said about the Poonam Mahajan, I have a good relation with the family, and I don't think that's anything happened.
Sir, my last question to you. We spoke to the Prime Minister 2 days ago. He said the sympathy is with the BJP because Uddhav Thackeray betrayed the BJP. We had a relationship with Balasaheb Thackeray, with the Shiv Sena, but there are two Shiv Senas now, there are two Pawar factions. The voters of Maharashtra are confused, is what many say. Do you think the sympathy is with the BJP? Is that something that will work?
It's not a question of sympathy. It's a question of the total faith of a common man in BJP. See, even though there is no question of the betrayal, now there is an illegal endorsement on this issue, that who is real and who is not real. So whatever the Shiv Sena, which are being under the command of Mr. Shinde, that is being recognized as a real Shiv Sena. So I don't want to go into that politics, but I would say that BJP is a major player in the whole things, and the common man has a tremendous faith in BJP as well as Shiv Sena, led by the Balasaheb Thackeray, and the, so far as the other Rashtravadi, the NCP, the partner, and the RPI, led by Mr. Rathod.
I hope your confidence translates into votes as well for you. All the best, sir, and thank you so much for speaking with us.
Thank you.
Women are silent voters in every election. That's really what we speak of. That's really what we hear of after every election. The turnout among women voters is also very, very high in the recent past. That's something that gives credence. That's something that gives confidence to the BJP is what they believe. Their schemes that are women-centric have worked. That is what gives them the vote of confidence. That is what gives them the ballot every time there's an election at the national level or at the state level as well. So let's ask the women of this particular constituency, what is it that their issue is, what is it that they want? आप इलेक्शन में जब वोट करेंगे तो आप किस मुद्दे पे करेंगे? किसी मुद्दे पे करेंगे या मोदी जी के लिए वोट होगा या किसी और ऑपोजिशन लीडर के लिए वोट होगा?
मोदी जी के लिए वोट होगा।
तो कोई इश्यूज नहीं है, कोई आपको समस्या नहीं है यहाँ पे?
नहीं, हम लोग जब से उनको वोट कर रहे हैं तब से हम बहुत सिक्योर है इधर।
मुंबई तो हमेशा से सिक्योर रहती थी, ऐसे हम कहते थे कि मुंबई में सेफ्टी सिक्योरिटी का कोई इशू नहीं होता।
जब से मोदी जी को वोट कर रहे तब से हम ज्यादा सिक्योर है।
आपको लगता है जो डेवलपमेंट हो रहा है, जो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बढ़ रहा है, जैसे मेट्रो आई है, रोड्स बन रहे हैं, आपको लगता है ये कुछ सालों में ज्यादा हो रहा है या ये हमेशा से होता था? जैसे ऑपोजिशन कहती है कि बीजेपी सिर्फ क्रेडिट ले रही है, काम तो हम भी करते थे।
नहीं, अभी मोदी आया तो सब अच्छे हो रहे हैं, हम लोग को लेडीज को भी अच्छे है और चावल भी सब अच्छे मिल रहे हैं हम लोग को। पहला पैसा लेके लेता था, अभी तो सब सुरक्षित हो रहे हैं लेडीज को सब। मोदी को हम लोग को मोदी को वोट देने चाहिए हम लोग को। मोदी आएगा तो सब लेडीज को भी अच्छा हो जाएगा ऐसा।
और आपको क्या लगता है, क्या मुद्दे हैं? कुछ है, कोई इशू है, कुछ है जिस पे स्पेसिफिकली काम करना चाहिए जो भी पार्टी में है, जो भी पावर में है?
नहीं, मोदी नहीं है तो कुछ नहीं है देश में, क्योंकि मोदी है तो सब कुछ है। और मोदी है जो आए तो हम लोग को मतलब हर चीज के लिए सुविधा हुआ, हर चीज के लिए मतलब हमको कैसा मोदी के लिए मतलब चाहिए। मोदी मतलब है तो है,
मोदी है तो मुमकिन है। व्हाट द बीजेपी बिलीव्स इज दैट व्हाट द वोटर आल्सो बिलीव्स, दैट्स रियली व्हाट्स गोइंग टू बी इम्पॉर्टेंट। एंड एज फार एज मुंबई इज कंसर्न, वी आर गोना फाइंड दैट आउट इन द फिफ्थ फेज व्हेन ऑल ऑफ द सिटी वोट्स। दैट इज गोना हैपन ऑन द 20th ऑफ मे। वेल, द ऑपोजिशन ऑफ कोर्स फील्स दैट मोदी इज नॉट इनफ, देयर आर इश्यूज, द वर्क ऑन ग्राउंड इज रियली रियली इम्पॉर्टेंट। मेनी ऑफ द सिटिंग मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट ऑफ द बीजेपी हैव नॉट डन दैट वर्क इज व्हाट ऑपोजिशन कैंडिडेट्स बिलीव, व्हिच इज व्हाई दे थिंक दे हैव अ फाइटिंग चांस। इट्स नॉट अबाउट सिंपथी, इट्स नॉट अबाउट splits in the family or the party, it's about your work that will do your talking. That's what the opposition believes, that's what gives them the confidence that this is not the BJP's election to win. They say the opposition does have a fighting chance, especially in a state like Maharashtra. We caught up with a candidate from the opposition camp as well, Anil Desai, a Rajya Sabha member of parliament, again making his debut as far as electoral politics go. He is fighting on a ticket from the UBT faction of the Shiv Sena. He is going to be taking on Rahul Shivare of the BJP on of the Shinde Sena. It's a Sena versus Sena fight as far as the Mumbai South Central constituency is concerned. What does he think? Is the sympathy vote in his favor or in the other Sena's favor? Which Sena is going to emerge the winner on June 4th? Listen in to what he told me earlier today. The political heat is rising as the temperatures are rising here in Mumbai. We are seeing candidates make the pitch. The heat is not stopping any of them for going out and speaking to the voters, to asking for what their confidence is going to be in like. And we're here in the midst of a constituency that is a mix of both worlds. We're seeing the affluent part of the constituency as well and the not so affluent part. So it is a mixed voter base as far as the Mumbai Central South is concerned. Joined by the candidate here of the Sena UBT faction, Anil Desai, thank you so much for speaking with us to CNN News 18. You know, you've been in the Rajya Sabha for two terms now. What decided, what was prompting you to take the Lok Sabha plunge finally?
I did work in the Rajya Sabha for two long terms, 6 years, one term. Like 12 years I've spent in Rajya Sabha. And after that, instead, see, we are the foot soldiers, we are the soldiers in Shiv Sena. And as Shiv Sena, Uddhav Bala Sahib Thackeray party, our president Uddhav ji decided, and he said, it's a command like that, you need to be in the field. So I've accepted it, and I'm here in South Central Mumbai, and I've been in the field. You was today, and as you have said that not only the nature's heat is catching up, but political heat is also, the election heat is on, and it is rising by the day. And you go by the people electorate when you go around, you get to know what their issues are, what their problems they are facing, I mean, what basic amenities and facilities they are being deprived of, and what need to be done, and what were their expectations when they, in the last elections, they got their representative, public representative, that is in the form of MP or MLA, and corporators. The corporators, they have very high regard, like our Sradhatai Jadhav is there in front of you. The moment, I mean, she was just passing, Amit Shetty is there, his father did do a work here, Jagannath Shetty. And these people who really worked in this slum area, the people really owe them that the moment they saw her, they hugged her, they rushed her. So many people came and they were praising, you know, how your father worked, how Sradhatai worked. I mean, right from payment work to drainage and all that, and pathetic condition what we've seen just now. I mean, they were yelling, they were crying.
You know, the sitting MP here is from the other Sena faction. So it is a direct Sena versus Sena fight that we are going to be seeing in this seat, like many other seats that we are seeing in Mumbai, across Maharashtra as well. How do you think that is going to pan out to be? Do you think that there would be some confusion among voters about which Sena they want to choose? What are they really talking about?
Confusion is being spread by the other side. People of the constituency, their electorate is well aware, because just 2 years back what has happened, more than 2 years back what has happened in Maharashtra, kind of conspiracy which was hatched, and the sitting CM then, Uddhav Thackerayji, who was leading the Mahavikas Agadi entire alliance, and he was doing very well. The way he was unseated by way of a conspiracy which people of Maharashtra had never seen. And right from that day, people here are restless. There is resentment in the electorate. People want to change it, want to set it right again. And they were waiting all along that BMC election, which was due more than 2 years back. I mean, it has been held back for political motives. And as BJP has done it, I mean, they are playing games with the people which they should not. And then BMC elections were kept in abeyance for no reason. They are giving reasons. They are giving, coming out with the pleas that, I mean, there is a plea going on in the Supreme Court which is pending, and that is being done by our side. I mean, which is not true. They could have very well given a say in the Supreme Court, and the elections could be held. And that would have changed the entire scenario.
Do you think the sympathy factor is going to make an effect as far as this election goes? Because the Prime Minister spoke to us as well, and he says that the BJP will have the sympathy, especially as far as Shiv Sena is concerned, because the BJP had ties with the Shiv Sena since Balasaheb's time, and it was Uddhav Thackeray who betrayed us. So the BJP will get the sympathy vote, is what the Prime Minister says.
Instead of anyone saying, those who have done damage, those who have broken the parties, people are aware of it, and they are the best judge. So they will be doing the rest. So they know, instead of political rhetorics, and this is not going to work. So who has done what, that is in the memory of people, and people are waiting for that. And that day is not too far. It is 20th of May. The people will show where we are and what justice we want. If you can't give justice, there is a provision in the Constitution of India that as a simple citizen, as a voter, you have every right to choose your representative, and they are going to exercise it.
Absolutely. The voter knows for sure, and the voter will decide. All the best to you, sir, for your contest. May the best man win, or may the best Shiv Sena win, if we were talking about Mumbai and the fight here. We will keep getting you more such voices from Mumbai. Our coverage here on Election Highway will continue. You've heard the candidate, but what is it that the people of the constituency really want as far as Mumbai South Central is concerned? Political parties are, of course, going to be making their pitch. It is a Sena versus Sena fight. But what exactly has happened in the last 5 years? Has anything actually happened, or is there a lot more to be wanting for? We ask the people who stay here. They, of course, have their own political affiliations. They've been campaigning for certain candidates, being a part of their support system as well. But let's talk about the constituency. Yahan ke issues exactly kya hai?
यहाँ पे सबसे ज़्यादा इशू है, ये पूरा लोकेलिटी स्लम्स का है, तो यहाँ पे छोटी छोटी समस्या है जो है, जैसे पानी की, ड्रेनेज की और शौचालय की, और स्लम रीडेवलपमेंट के लिए जिसे लोगों को घर बना के देना स्लम्स की जगह पे, ये सारी सबसे बड़ी समस्या यही है। और यहाँ पे कोई ऐसा बड़ा कोई इशू नहीं है, यहाँ पिछले दस साल से ये लोकसभा के जो हमारे राहुल शिवाले साहब है, कोई काम नहीं किया इन्होंने, मतलब 10 साल में इस स्लम में स्पेशली कभी कोई काम नहीं किया उन्होंने, यहाँ तक कि स्पेसिफिकली ये एरिया में तो कभी आए भी नहीं हो। और एक उम्मीद से है, अब लोग इंतज़ार कर रहे हैं कि मतलब हमको कभी ये मौका मिले वोट देने के लिए, तो सारी जनता को एकदम अच्छे से अवेयर है कि हमको क्या करना है। और ये तकरीबन ये 5-6 साल के बाद ये पहली बार जनता को अच्छा मौका मिल रहा है कि हम लोग ये वोट डाल के और ऐसे कैंडिडेट को जीता कर लाए जो ध्रुवीकरण और बुराइयों को ना देखकर मतलब लोगों के ग्राउंड के मुद्दों पर काम करे। सिर्फ बातों से काम नहीं चलने वाला है, अब काम करके दिखाना होगा लोगों को।
तो अनिल देसाई वो कैंडिडेट है जो वो काम करके दिखाएंगे?
यस बिल्कुल, हमें भरोसा है। और एक बहुत अपने दिल से हमको ऐसा लगता है कि जिस तरह 10 साल हमने स्लम के, हम पैदा भी स्लम में ही हुए, आज भी हम वही नाली में हैं। आज अभी भी हमारी इच्छा है कि ये जो स्लम है हम एसआरए में जाए, माड़ा में जाए, कोई तो हमें अपनाए। आज हम 10 साल से परेशान हो रहे हैं, हर जगह कोई ना कोई बिल्डर आता है तोड़ देता है, क्या हो रहा है। आज 10 साल से जो हमारे इससे पहले कैंडिडेट थे राहुल रमेश शिवाड़े सर जी, उन्होंने 10 साल बोलते हैं सब लोग दिल्ली जाएंगे गली नहीं भूलेंगे, हम गली में रहने वाले लोग हैं, हम यही चाहते हैं कि ये जो 10 साल हमने जो गवा दिए, आने वाले टाइम में हम हमारी पूरे जितने भी हमारे स्लम के लोग हैं, हमने ठान लिया है कि अब की बार पार, हमने ये ठान लिया है। और इंशाल्लाह आने वाले टाइम पे हम हमारे शिक्षक मजबूत कैंडिडेट हमारे राहुल सर जी, देसाई सर जी, अनिल देसाई सर जी, उनको हम चुन के लाएंगे और अपने मांगों को पूरा करवाएंगे। और आने वाले टाइम पे सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट जब हमारे अनिल देसाई साहब जब पहुंचेंगे, तो आने वाले मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि 10 सालों में हम ये स्लम से निकल के बिल्डिंग के इमारतों में चले जाएंगे, बस हम यही चाहते हैं।
अभी शिवसेना वर्सेस शिवसेना फाइट हो रहा है, दो शिवसेना का इधर लड़ाई हो रहा है, इधर भी जो दो कैंडिडेट्स हैं दोनों फैक्शन के हैं, आपको लगता है इन लड़ाई से कुछ एक्चुअली में जो वोटर है उनको कोई फर्क पड़ता है?
सुनो मैम, जो वोटर है, जो शिवसेना के जो वोटर है, गए वो कार्यकर्ते गए ले, वोटर तो इधर उद्धव बाला साहब ठाकरे के साथ ही है, जितने भी हैं सिर्फ बोलते हैं कि इलेक्शन आन दो, 20 तारीख को हम लोग जो करना है अपना उद्धव बाला साहब ठाकरे को कैसा जिताने का है हमारा है। जो गए वो नकली, जो है असली इधर ही है पावरफुल, जो गए वो राहुल सेवाले गए, वो 10 साल तो इधर कभी आया नहीं, मुँह भी नहीं दिखाया, और उसके साथ जो गई टीम है वो उसके चेले चपेले, कार्यकर्ते तो सब इधर ही है, हम लोग भी युवा सैनिक अपने शाखा के कार्यकर्ते हैं, उप शाखा प्रमुख है, और हमारे जितने भी कार्यकर्ते हैं इधर सब है, और जो मतदार है वो भी इधर ही है, सब मतदार कोई गया नहीं, सब मतदार इधर ही है। जो आने वाले 20 तारीख को है उद्धव बाला साहेब ठाकरे, अनिल देसाई इधर वार्ड से तो कम से कम जीत के जाएंगे।
अनिल देसाई इज कंटेस्टिंग फ्रॉम हियर, इधर और बाकी बहुत सीट पे ऐसे है, सेना वर्सेस सेना का फाइट हम देख रहे हैं, लेकिन आपके दो एलाइज भी हैं, कांग्रेस भी है उसमें, शरद पवार की फैक्शन भी है, ऐसे बहुत लोगों को लगता है कि वोटर में कौन सी अलायंस को चुनना है उसी में कन्फ्यूजन है, ऐसा होता है वोटर को लेके?
नहीं, वोटर को कुछ सब लोगों को पता है कि वो गए वो सब डमी लोग से गए ले वहाँ पे, जो है वो असली यहाँ पे है, सब वोटर लोगों को पता है कि किसको जिताना है और किसको नहीं जिताना है, सब लोगों को पता है उद्धव बाला साहब ठाकरे के कैंडिडेट अनिल देसाई सब खड़े हैं, तो उनको ही जिताना है, ये सब लोगों को पता है, सब कैंडिडेट लोगों को।
सो द वोटर्स नो बेस्ट इज व्हाट मेनी पीपल बिलीव हियर, व्हाट एग्जैक्टली विल हैपन एंड व्हाट द वोटर विल चूज वी विल फाइंड आउट ऑन द 20th ऑफ मे व्हेन ऑल ऑफ मुंबई वोट्स, ऑल कंस्टिट्यूएंसीज इन मुंबई विल वोट ऑन द 20th ऑफ मे इन द 5th फेज। जून 4th ऑफ कोर्स इज व्हेन वी विल फाइंड आउट वेयर द प्रूफ ऑफ द पुडिंग लाइज। On that note, it's time for a quick pause. Hitting the brakes here on Election Highway, but on the other side of a very quick break, we'll have an exclusive conversation with Union Minister and the candidate from this particular constituency, which is Mumbai North, Piyush Goyal. He'll be joining us shortly. Don't go anywhere. ठीक। Welcome back. You're watching this version, this episode of Election Highway. We're coming straight to you from Mumbai. Piyush Goyal, Union Minister, a candidate in the fray for the first time in electoral politics. He's here with us. Our Mumbai Bureau Chief, Vinaya Deshpande, my colleague there, in fact, with Piyush Goyal. He is going to be joining us shortly for a conversation here exclusively on this edition of the Election Highway. What is it that are issues that are close to his heart? What is it that he wants the voters to believe in and to vote on? We'll have all of that conversation with him. A jam-packed schedule for all candidates, of course. We're less than a month away before Mumbai votes. No difference for Mr. Piyush Goyal as well. Taking out time exclusively for us here on CNN News 18 on this edition. And he'll be joining us in just a few seconds from now. In fact, here he is.
Hi.
Hello, sir. How are you?
Good.
If you could just come here. Yes. So, Piyush Goyal joining us here on this edition of the Election Highway. So congratulations on filing your nomination today. The fight is now final. We have less than a month to go.
20 days
to be exact. Politics is not new to you. You come from a political family, so to say. You've been in Parliament for decades now, for many, many terms. What took you so long to take the plunge into electoral politics?
Well, I think it was the party's decision to send me to the Rajya Sabha. I got a great opportunity to serve the nation as a member of the Rajya Sabha. And I'm really delighted that the Prime Minister has given me this opportunity to serve the people of North Mumbai. With the feet on the ground, connecting with the people at the local level, understanding the real day-to-day issues and working towards finding solutions is a great joy. And my last few days have been extremely exciting, making a lot of new friends, making a lot of new ideas. A lot of ideas are coming to mind about what we can do here. And I do believe that the future of North Mumbai will only get better if Prime Minister Modi gets his 400 plus and I get an opportunity to serve this constituency.
You know, we speak of 400 plus, but Maharashtra is a state where some political analysts, journalists who've toured the state believe yahan thoda mamla fas sakta hai. 400 par is not necessarily something that could translate as far as Maharashtra goes, because we've seen the kind of difference of opinion, splits in families and parties. Do you agree?
I don't agree at all. In fact, if at all there is a little bit of a splinter group that is decided not to be a part of the main Shiv Sena or the main Rashtravadi Congress. Other than that, there's no challenge to us. We are waiting for a Congress candidate for God knows how long. I don't even know now whether it'll be Congress or Shiv Sena. They don't seem to have a candidate. Very clearly, the election is being fought on Modi ji ki guarantee. The Sankalp Patra lays out his vision for the next 25 years in the Amrit Kal. He's given a very concrete set of programs which are truly visionary in nature. And I have absolutely no doubt in my mind that 400 seats is a reality, will be the result on 4th of June. Maharashtra will be very high up in the numbers over there. The small faction led by Mr. Sharad Pawar is a minuscule splinter group. The whole party is with Ajit Dada, who's the natural leader of the NCP, if you know Maharashtra politics. The entire party, all the MPs, all the MLAs are with Eknath Shinde. They were fed up of the family politics that they had to witness. And they also recognized that they had won in 2019 on Prime Minister Modi's name. They had won on the good governance and the work of Prime Minister Modi. It was an alliance that was between the BJP and Sena. Sadly, for personal political gain and for his ambition to become Chief Minister, Mr. Uddhav Thackeray completely killed the ideology of the Shiv Sena. He let down the Hindutva philosophy on which the Shiv Sena was built. He totally forgot about the promise made by Balasaheb Thackeray ji to the people of Maharashtra, who had once said that I would rather close the party, wind it up rather than join with the Congress. Now, such a person can only at best be a splinter group to try and protect his son or promote his son, Mr. Aditya Thackeray ji. Other than that, I don't think there's any traction or any kind of enthusiasm amongst the voters and the people to support such leaders.
But you know, we're talking about family splitting, and it's the sympathy factor really that's also been spoken of. The Prime Minister spoke to our network just 2 days ago, and he in fact said that the sympathy is with the BJP in
obviously,
this case.
Because we are the ones who are wrong. Devendra Fadnavis was to be the Chief Minister. Every rally of the Prime Minister, of the Home Minister, Mr. Amit Shah, our President, all of them would only speak about Devendra being Chief Minister with Mr. Uddhav Thackeray sitting on stage. He never contested it even once. I don't know where, from a figment of imagination, he thought that he should be the Chief Minister. So it was clearly the BJP which was let down. The people of Maharashtra were betrayed by Mr. Uddhav Thackeray for his petty political ambition. And I think this time around they will give a fitting response and reply to the betrayal of Mr. Uddhav Thackeray.
We're talking of the constituency. You spoke of Mumbai North and going forward from here. Infrastructure is something that we talk about. You're talking about healthcare, you're talking about hospitals. That's something that's very close to your heart as well. That's something that you want to focus on?
That's something which you have already worked upon. When I first came into North Mumbai after being announced as a candidate, and I was meeting the constituents and trying to assess their needs and requirements, one of the major issues that came out was the lack of high quality healthcare in this region. So almost all the way up to Palghar and on the other side up to Andheri and Bandra, there's no good hospital in the whole area. Though they are very good doctors living here, but they're all working far away. So should anybody have any problem, they have no choice but to drive 2 hours for medical treatment. So I'd propose that when I get elected, I will look at a large multi-speciality hospital coming up here. During the course of my travels in the constituency, we came across a friend who's plans to set up a hospital, small hospital here. But I was able to persuade him and implore upon him that he should now set up a 1,000-bedded hospital. He has very kindly agreed. He has said that he will complete the 400-bed hospital now instead of 4 years by 17th of September 2026, which we celebrate as Service Day, Seva Divas. And going forward, in the next phase, he'll take it up to 1,000 beds. Multi-speciality, he's agreed to add neonatal ICU, he's agreed to add oncology with nuclear science and PET scan facilities. He's agreed to add a lithotripsy machine. So he's been very benevolent. He's agreed to expand his hospital from 4 lakh square feet to 16 lakh square feet, effectively giving the North Mumbai region the largest private hospital in the city of Mumbai, with the best of modern facilities, equipment, doctors, all in one roof, under one roof. And it will be a project which will be really worth over 6,000 crores in terms of the value of land, building and equipment and facilities. That's the kind of development that we can see in North Mumbai coming in the next few days.
Piyush ji, before we move forward, if I can just request you to come a little this side so our viewers can have a better look and not just hear you better. Our cameras are there. The election highway bus, of course, here is in Maharashtra, in Mumbai. That's where we're starting from. I want to ask you, as far as the bigger picture is concerned, is a fractured opposition advantage BJP? Or do you think they'll eventually cobble up together and try and stop the Modi juggernaut or the BJP juggernaut?
Did their best to try and cobble together a coalition. Look at their state of affairs. Kerala, Pinarayi Vijayan is cursing Rahul Gandhi. Rahul Gandhi is giving it back to CPM. Ek jagah dosti, dusri jagah kuski. With Aam Aadmi Party in Delhi, they have a ragmatack seat adjustment. Of course, the Delhi Congress chief has only quit now. But in Punjab, they are fighting cats and dogs. So again, their people are quitting the party. So I think Mr. Rahul Gandhi has taken it upon himself as his duty to fulfill Mahatma Gandhi's desire that the Congress party should wind up.
You know, you spoke of Rahul Gandhi, we've spoken of it a couple of days ago as well, where you said that not two seats, maybe he should fight from four or five seats. Perhaps that's when it'll be safe for him. Do you actually believe that? Do you think he's not going back to Amethi because he knows there is no chance that they can actually revive the bastion there?
Mrs. Smriti Irani will defeat him with at least twice, if not more, the margin that she defeated him with last time. He's so unpopular that anywhere he stands, the BJP or NDA candidate will celebrate. And I would invite him to come and stand in my constituency in Uttar Mumbai.
And you've challenged him to stand against the Prime Minister as well, as far as Varanasi is concerned.
Anywhere, it'll only make the job of the NDA candidate easier.
Do you think it's because of Rahul Gandhi specifically that the Congress is in further decline now?
Quite a bit so. I mean, it's leadership that defines the character of a party. We have with us a great leader, honest, hardworking, extremely visionary and nationalist leader like Mr. Narendra Modi. We have a number of leaders like Mr. Amit Shah, Mr. J.P. Nadda, Mr. Rajnath Singh. The whole plethora of leadership of the BJP demonstrates confidence, demonstrates a sense of purpose, sense of nation building, a sense of desire to see a powerful India. Whereas on the other hand, the Congress is a single family party. The power will always be derived only from a family surname. You have a party where even their own senior people don't get a chance to even meet Mr. Rahul Gandhi. I mean, so many of their leaders have come out of the Congress telling us horrid tales of how for years they could not even get an audience with their leader. Himanta Biswa Sarma, for example, was insulted and thrown out. What did they do with Mr. Narasimha Rao, the architect of reforms originally in 1991? They did not even allow his body to enter the Congress office. They shut the door. What did they do with Bharat Ratna Baba Saheb Ambedkar? The Nehru Gandhi family defeated him in Bhandara, defeated him in Mumbai, never gave him a Bharat Ratna, never gave him any respect. It is Mr. Modi who gave the punch teeth, who is now setting up the memorial in honor of Baba Saheb Ambedkar in Hindu Mill, which the textile ministry has given. The place where he stayed in London is being converted into a memorial. So it is Narendra Modi ji who has really given honor to the legacy and wonderful work that Baba Saheb Ambedkar had done. I think the Congress is today paying for their sins.
Sir, I know you have a campaign rally to rush for, but one last question. You know, just a few months ago, in fact, you were at the forefront of negotiating with farmers up north when you were in the national capital with other of your cabinet colleagues. Speaking of farmers here in Maharashtra, there is a lot of anger against the BJP among the farmers in Marathwada and Vidarbha, is what many people believe, is what the opposition has been speaking of as well. Specifically, if we talk about onion exports, something that you would like to address?
It has already been addressed, madam. Onion exports were banned, or minimum export price was imposed, or export duty was introduced by Shri Sharad Pawar as the agriculture minister of the UPA government from 4 to 14. It is usually done when there is a shortage of crop or when the prices in the domestic market go up to high levels. Mr. Sharad Pawar seems to have forgotten all his own actions. Only difference is, whenever he did it, he never bothered about the farmers. And the farmers suffered so much so that at times they had to throw their produce on the streets. Whereas Mr. Modi is very sensitive and he balanced the interests of farmers and consumers. So when the prices of any product go up, Mr. Modi has introduced two concepts, a buffer stock and a price stabilization fund. So when onion prices rose, for the consumer, we bought onion in large measure from the farmers through NAFED and NCCF, ensuring that the farmers get a fair value for their produce, and we sold it to the consumers at highly subsidized prices, 25 rupees a kilo, at over 21,000 outlets all over the country, so that neither do the consumers have to bear the burden and nor do the farmers suffer any impact. That way we balance the interests of both and ensured that farmers get a fair price, consumers are not put to a loss, and the government of Prime Minister Modi bore the brunt of the the cost of it with outlay of nearly 28,500 crores.
And that's really the Modi guarantee that the BJP is speaking of.
So if you look at onion prices for farmers today, same time last year or the year before last or the year before last, they were either selling onion at 6, 7 rupees or at times even lower. This time they're getting 15, 16 rupees for their onion. And NCCF NAFED is there. In case prices fall, they are ready to buy. 6 months ago, they bought at 23, 24 rupees. So NCCF NAFED have ensured the farmers get a fair price. I think what is bothering Mr. Sharad Pawar is this equilibrium that Mr. Modi has been successful in creating. He's very uncomfortable and he thought that attack is the best policy to defend his own mismanagement of the farmers' distress, onion farmers' distress, when he was the agriculture minister.
Which narrative will resonate, we'll find out sooner than later. So thank you so much for taking out the time and speaking with us here on CNN News 18. That was Piyush Goyal for you, exclusively speaking to us here on this edition of the Election Highway. CNN News 18's Election Highway has led to Maharashtra. We're here in Mumbai, in Amchi, Mumbai, the maximum city. The state of Maharashtra and the politics and the state of affairs here seems like it's in a muddle. What exactly is it that the voters are choosing from? We try and decode that on a plate of food. I'm joining you here from Dadar, which is the Gad of the Shiv Sena. Well, which Shiv Sena now, you might ask. But we are in the midst of the Sena Bhavan, which is the actual place, the birthplace, so to say, of Shiv Sena. My colleague Vinaya is also joining me here. We are going to be talking about Maharashtra politics over a plate of food that speaks of what Maharashtra is like.
Over some Maharashtrian food, Poonam?
Absolutely. And that's really what the state of affairs perhaps looks like. There is a lot to offer. You don't know what to pick from.
Well, what you are going to eat is something that resembles a lot more like Maharashtrian politics is misal right now. So it's all, everything mixed. But if you ask me what the politics of Maharashtra resembles today is more like the Gadbad Faluda, where it's not here on our plates today, but clearly, that is what it is, with strange bedfellows, with extremely unusual political combinations that have not been put to test in any elections till now. This is going to be an interesting election for Maharashtra and interesting political combinations to test out as well.
And from what I see on your plate, there's a lot of mango. It's mango season. It's also political season. The mango that stands out in your plate, is there one person that stands out in Mumbai or in this election in Mumbai for you?
Yes, this is the Chaitra Thali, as you know, this is the special Maharashtrian Thali for the season, Chaitra season. And I would say Amba Dal, which is this delicacy, which is spicy, which is salty and sour. That is what at least, you know, a few leaders in Maharashtra would look like. I do not know if anybody, the people of Maharashtra, would really resonate with something as sweet as the amaras right now, because the political atmosphere has really become so acerbic and so muddled that everyone has been indulging into a blame game. So it's more likely that, you know, Amba Dal is something that will be, that will resonate with the politics of Maharashtra. This is this is Ambyachi Kadhi. Again, something sweet and sour. And this is another Chaitra special, Poonam. This is Fansachi Kordi Bhaji. This is the
jackfruit.
Yeah. Dried jackfruit. And I think it's tempered with peanuts and it's dry fodni, as you say in Maharashtra. So let's see, this is the favorite coolant to keep you chilled in this poll season. This is the panha, which is made of raw mango. But Let us
and the
this.
Coolant really is required given the kind of heated arguments that we've seen between politicians.
Yes, and the rising temperatures as well. Mumbai has been phenomenally hot this season.
And amidst all of that, the election campaigning is still happening at a fever pitch. And talking about the area that we're in, like I was discussing right at the start, we're bang opposite to where Shiv Sena is. This was the birthplace of Shiv Sena. But which Shiv Sena is going to be emerging as, say, the winner as far as Mumbai is concerned, as far as at least this area is concerned?
This area, we are in Dadar, which is the hub of the Marathi Maharashtrian population. We are bang across the Shiv Sena Bhavan, which Uddhav Thackeray has been able to retain with him till now. The right, maybe 100 meters from here is Shiv Tirtha or Shivaji Park, the place from where Babasaheb Thackeray started his campaign speeches or annual Dasara rallies, yeah, as they say. And so, it's an extremely historic place for anybody in Mumbai, specifically for Maharashtrians. What's interesting is we are also 100 meters away from Raj Thackeray's house, Maharashtra Navnirman Sena, which has jumped into the electoral fray now, which now supports the BJP, the Narendra Modi, yeah, group. So now it is a Thackeray pitched against another Thackeray. So what the people here in Dadar at least have to choose from is not just one Sena versus another Sena. It's also one Thackeray versus another Thackeray.
So is that Thackeray going to be like that lemon on top of everything else that gives it the taste? Is that what is going to be, say, the X factor, so to say? Because many say that Raj Thackeray is not even a factor. He's had very little electoral success as far as Maharashtra goes. So will he actually be making a difference at all?
Well, that is what the BJP hopes for. What the BJP hopes to gain through this is the brand Thackeray, because they want to show that not only has the Shiv Sena been split, but that there is a bigger Thackeray brand that is standing by Eknath Shinde and by the BJP's dispensation as a whole. So they hope that it will bring in those additional votes. Even if it doesn't, it will at least help divide the Marathi vote so that the Shiv Sena led by Uddhav Thackeray faction, which is also believed to have some sympathy wave across here, will not garner all the Maharashtrian votes. So on that note, let's dig into our plates and see how this goes.
Absolutely, we've decoded what politics looks like. Now we're going to decode what's on our plate, and we're going to leave it at that. Vinay and I are going to continue to savor this. We hope you have enjoyed this episode of Election Highway. Thank you so much for tuning in.
Thank you.